Video games are wonderful creations, aren't they? While it might look all sleek and simple when compressed down to a disc or cartridge, if you want to step back in time a little, underneath all of that gloss is a war of code, barely constrained programming, and a digital world that is only ever a few steps away from breaking apart at the seams. This is the balance that every video game developer has to contend with. For while we are often stunned by incredible looking vistas or enthralled with huge and consuming boss battles, these moments can be utterly broken by players exploiting, hacking, or indeed cheesing the hell out of things. And as we are all human and therefore our natural instincts tell us to look for the easiest solution to most of our problems, we will of course hunt down every single exploit we can in order to gain an advantage over the game itself. And these 10 entries on this list are just such examples of us being paradoxically too lazy to fully play by the game's rules, but have worked our asses off to find ways of buffing our characters and breaking the entire experience in equal measure. With this in mind, I'm Jules, this is WhatCulture.com, and these are 10 video game abilities that break the entire experience. Number 10. Jumping. Sonic Boom, Rise of Lyric. It might sound ridiculous that the simple act of jumping can indeed break Sonic Boom, Rise of Lyric, but then again, this title's entire existence is more than a little bit of a joke. Sonic Boom, Rise of Lyric promised to be a soft reset of everything we'd known about Sonic up until this point, and was an attempt to wash away the sour taste in the mouths of fans that had accumulated over years of mediocre, badly programmed titles. It's just a shame that it was a mediocre and badly programmed game then, wasn't it? The now infamous jump glitch, which is performed by pausing the game mid-jump, unpausing, and then hitting jump immediately after, meant that players were able to skip entire sections of the game in entirely hilarious fashion. For a franchise so focused on speeding around the floor to be undone by a slow creeping up into the air is a rather humiliating blow, to say the least. Still, if you fancy not playing through the levels, jumping is apparently always an option. Or it was, since it's now been pitched. Consider this actually a broke the experience rather than breaks, if you want to get pedantic about it. Number 9. Alchemy and Enchanting. The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. Now, originally I was going to include the smithing perk abuse as this entry, but in all honesty, it has been ages since it's been patched, and I've already done a patched one, so it feels a little bit cheeky to include two abilities that were actually patched out of the game. So instead, let's talk about a fork that can one-shot every enemy in the game. Yeah, I knew you'd like that. So what you need to do in order to conjure up this cutlery from hell is exploit the hell out of alchemy and enchantment by creating potions that boost your enchantment, then making enchanted items while boosted that affect your alchemy skills, and repeating this process, you can end up with potions that increase your enchanting skill by tens of thousands. You can then use these steroidal spell-based liquids to enchant items, such as this humble fork that previously only did one measly point of damage, to produce ludicrous effects. Fancy a fork that does 500,000 points of fire damage? Go ahead. Or maybe you want to be a pseudo-culinary vampire and have chosen to make the fork steal over a million points of health per hit. Whatever you fancy, alchemy and enchanting are your best mates for the job, and they are so utterly broken. Number 8. The Ring of the Lucii. Final Fantasy 15. When you think of Final Fantasy weapons, you likely immediately go to the likes of Cloud's Buster Sword or Squall's Gunblade. Hell, you might even go to Wacker's Blitzball for how offbeat it is. However, if you're a fan of Final Fantasy XV, you'll know that the real King Supreme of banter is actually the Ring of the Lucii. Now, this devilishly handsome piece of jewelry is integral to the plot of the game, so much so that when you hear about its raw power, you don't actually believe that you'll get a chance to wield it. Oh, how wrong we are. For this ring casts, in exchange for a chunk of MP, death on all foes around Noctis. Now, death is a spell with a pretty low chance to hit, but when it does, woof, watch out. Players began to test this on everything they came across upon unlocking it, and one of the most surprising foes that was felled by this finger ring of doom was the Adamantoise, the toughest and most resilient boss in the entire game. After devs noticed this, they went about patching it. Not to fix the ring, of course. It was actually to remove the limitations, making it even more powerful. Seriously, in the game's current state, you can pretty much one-shot every enemy and boss, bar a few exceptions. It does take a while sometimes, and a bit of good luck to go off, but man, talk about a game-breaker. Number 7. Cops Ignore Crimes. Grand Theft Auto V Online. One of the most appealing facets of the Grand Theft Auto series isn't simply the prospect of committing crimes and getting away with it, but actively barely surviving a desperate chase against police, private security firms, and even the army. These are the moments that you're going to remember and tell your friends about. But then again, maybe we're looking at it in the wrong way. Maybe there's an even greater story to tell by stealing one of the most powerful bits of kit from right under the nose of law enforcement without them even knowing. This leads us to the brilliantly exploitable ability found in GTA 5's online section dubbed Cops Ignore Crimes, a feature that you get pretty early on through taking jobs from Lester. The idea of the ability is that you can call up Lester and he'll give you 1 minute of pure freedom wherein you can kill, rob, or destroy, and the cops will turn a blind eye. So what some clever sods did was find out that it takes just about this time to hop into the airbase, scream over to a jet and steal it, thus giving you air superiority and zero consequences. Well, until you decide to unleash it on the rest of the server, that is. But still, nice. Number 6, Kill Jaden's Cunning, World of Warcraft. So yes, before you pipe up, it is true that this ability was actually so overpowered that it was removed entirely from the game. But just think about that for a moment, that on the world's most popular MMORPG, there existed an ability so broken that it threatened to engulf the entire game as we knew it. Well, okay, maybe that's a little overdramatic, but still, Kill Jaden's Cunning was truly a slice of pure anarchic fun before it was patched out, as this talent for warlocks allowed you to cast while moving. Now, I know while it might not seem like much, but really think about that. In every instance up until now, the warlock had to plant themselves down to cast their almighty spells. But now, well, they could just keep backing up all the while slinging out the damage. This had a knock-on effect with some pretty huge repercussions, as now support classes didn't need to worry so much about buffing warlocks' defenses, and tanks could plow on without fear of having to drop back and save their weaker allies. All in all, this one change upended the team dynamic entirely, so no wonder it got dropped. Number 5, the Specialist Strike Pack, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. Modern Warfare 3 was kind of a bit of a strange moment for the series, a bit of a difficult second album affair despite being so long in the tooth as a franchise. Still, despite its issues, the multiplayer was still an absolute blast, and once more offered players the chance to unlock and customize their loadouts however they saw fit, with more guns, mods, and killstreaks than you could shake a very explosive stick at. However, for the purists out there, there was only one option. At level 20, you got to unlock the Specialist Strike Package, and trust me, this soon became one of the most broken options possible, or at least it was in the right hands. You see, instead of rewarding players with kill streaks upon racking up the deaths, this path would instead give out perks. And as we know, perks in modern warfare are like blessings from God themselves. With perks, you could smash opponents with bullets through walls, move without any hindrance while strafing, aim and reload quicker, and of course, hear enemies coming from a mile away. So imagine the zen-like god status one achieves when they hit 8 kills and unlock everything. I know, disgusting, right? Number 4, just, kicking, Dragon Ball Z Sagas. Each time I think about this game, I die a little inside. Dragon Ball Z Sagas was the first taste of the franchise on the original Xbox that they got, and I feel so sorry for those that picked it up, as the only thing Z about the title was its letter grade ranking when it came to bloody quality. No better is this lack of polish expressed than by the ability to stun lock every enemy in the game just by simply kicking them. Or even technically, it's less than that, because in order to get this infinite loop of damage, you just needed to not finish off a combo, meaning that the first punch and kick of a chain are going to be your best friend in sagas. True, it will take you an ice age with some bosses to beat them, but then again, seeing as the alternative is hearing them spout out rubbish lines of dialogue and hit you with energy blasts over and over, this definitely feels like the lesser of two evils. Number 3, Berserker Darts, Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. The Assassin's Creed series is one that prides itself on well-calculated hit-and-run style contract killing. It's one that aims to make you not only feel like a badass, but look like one as well. Every target is presented in such a way that there are multiple options for you to get your stab on, and if things do go to pot, well, you've got tricks and toys at your disposal that will give you the upper hand. However, what if the thought of running over those rooftops and parrying blades just gets you a bit sweaty? Well, if you want a much easier time, then just unlock the Berserk Darts in Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. You see, these darts take all the skill out of assassinations, has, with just one single well-aimed puff at the target, they will enter into a rage-induced rampage and will attack anyone around them, including their bodyguards. As the bodyguards are much better equipped than regular grunts, they'll have no issue cutting down their former boss, leaving you to gloat from up above and collect the reward. That kind of ruins the tone though, right? Number 2, Shock Gloves, Batman Arkham Origins. One of the best things about Juicy Bruce Wayne is that he's a man with a meticulous approach to fighting crime, having trained his body and brain beyond peak physical conditioning, and isn't afraid to use whatever he can to get the upper hand on his opponent. And it's definitely his hands that provide would-be enemies a shock when it comes to the Arkham Origins game, as thanks to the demise of the quite frankly pathetic Electrocutioner, you get access to his homemade shock gloves, and boy howdy, do they break the game. With the gloves equipped, you can now bypass armored enemy defenses as well as shielded foes, and you can use them to trigger electronics in the battle environment without the need to switch over to other gadgets. Plus, to top all of this off, every hit does double the damage of regular punches, meaning that if you activate them, you're basically playing on easy mode. And when you consider that this game is meant to get harder as it goes on, it feels completely out of place. Still, it's hilarious fun to use. And number 1, Talisman Sloth, Neo. It's pretty safe to say that Neo is a rather hard game. Not just content in shadowing the likes of Dark Souls, this series then slides up and garrots the poor Sun Bro with a ludicrous amount of menus, extra features, and customization that adds in a whole new depth that is as brilliant to explore as it is baffling to newcomers. In fact, it might make your head spin so much that you may just wish for the game to just chill out for a second. Well, luckily for you, the Sloth Talisman has your back, as it will literally do just that, making enemies move at a snail's pace for a few moments, allowing you to line up the perfect strike or, as is more likely considering the brutal combat, a chance to drop back and recuperate. But wait, there's more, for this talisman can be used twice and it also affects bosses. Yes, that's right, this talisman will buy you about a minute's worth of slowdown exploiting to dish out a huge amount of damage on even the toughest boss, thus rendering one of the biggest aspects of the franchise into a much less challenging affair. You're welcome. And there we go, my friends. Those were 10 video game abilities that break the entire experience. I hope that you enjoyed that, and please let me know what you thought about it down in the comments section below, as well as any other examples that you would have had for a list of your own design. If you want to chat to me further, you can do so over on Twitter at RetroJ with a zero, or you can swing by Live and Let's Dice, where I stream every single Wednesday and Sunday. That's good streaming, brother. But before I go, I just want to say one thing. We detailed today about video game abilities that broke the entire experience, and I'm going to break the experience of just being a list and address you, yes, you, my friend at home. I hope that you're doing all right. I hope that you're treating yourself fairly, both mentally and physically, because you know what, my friend? You deserve that. You deserve love, happiness, and success, and do not let anyone or anything else tell you otherwise. I believe in you, so treat yourself with love, my friend. Do it. Do it now. As always, I've been Jules. You have been awesome. Never forget that. And I'll speak to you soon. Bye.